Hello. So the other day I wrecked my VTX. I put the power of the VTX on a switch, now using a command line. Doing that, well, that switch becomes mandatory. So if you like crash the quad, in my case into a tree, the plug of the antenna just went unplugged. And normally these VTX have the safety feature that if they get out of the antenna or if the chip goes too hot, they just go into pit mode. But because I had it on a switch that became mandatory, and that feature, safety feature, it was like overwritten, and it self-destruct because the antenna became disconnected. So I bought this VTX, which, well, it's a cyclone. I don't know what kind of VTX, how good it is, but it was very good for the money. And it says it supports smart audio, and it has here data. It's very easy to solder. It came into this case, and it has this cable to solder on, and to the flight controller, which I'm not going to do that. No, I may probably, but I have from the other VTX, I have the cable. I just cut that off, and I have a plug. So, on the flight controller. So what I'm gonna do right now is just solder this, and it goes straight in order. I just looked before on the diagram of the flight controller. It just goes like smart audio, video, plus and minus 5 volts. So on the VTX, it goes like the same, and I'm just going to solder that and plug it into the flight controller. Hope it works. Doesn't really have any reason to not work, so yeah. Anyway, I'm going to do like this. First, I'm not going to put you to all the process that, I mean, soldering, it's a thing that I suppose we are over it. So yeah, I'm just going to put some solder on the pads. And now this VTX supports like 7 to 20 25 volts, I think 26 volts, but I'm just going to hook it up to the flight controller. So yeah, that doesn't really, it's a feature that I don't need. Okay, that's the data, smart audio. Okay. So they should be okay. Now the port for this, it's here. Okay, I'm gonna hook up the antenna. And I'm going to hook up a battery and my goggles. Okay, so right now, the moment of truth. Well, things happened, and that's okay, because it has to blink like that, I think. Well, yet. Okay, so it works. I'm seeing things, okay? But anyway, this receiver compared with the other one is a piece of crap. I don't know if the antenna it's really the problem or something else, but definitely I cannot show you what I'm trying to. Anyway, so I have in my goggles I have like a scale, and that scale with the original one, it was like 4 lines with signal. With this one, there are like 10 lines. I don't know, it's probably the antenna, because one of these antennas, they are known to be like a piece of crap. But I remember I had this with this, the same antenna, only with the plug, and it would work great. It has like, it was very narrow in frequency. So if I should bought one of these, this is like, I don't know where to buy this. I found something like similar, but this VTX that came with the original quad that I paid like €80, it's way better than this one at emitting power. Probably because this was like, obviously, it is like, it's possible that this was like 200 milliwatts maximum power, and this one is 400 milliwatts. It is very possible right now that this is set like for 400 milliwatts. I have to look it with the blinks of these LEDs, which sucks.